Official groundbreaking ceremonies were held on Monday, August 25th, for the Monongahela-Sewanee portion of the Mountain Goat Trail, as well as for the Monongahela Pedestrian Enhancement Project. The ceremonies were held at 4 p.m. next to Monongahela City Hall for the Pedestrian Enhancement Project and at 4:30 p.m. next to Dollar General in Monongahela for the Mountain Goat Trail Project. The 3-mile Monongahela-Sewanee section of the Mountain Goat Trail will extend from the Dollar General store in Monongahela west to the current terminus of the trail on Highway 156 in Sewanee. It will create a 5-mile walking and biking path linking the towns of Monongahela and Sewanee. The pedestrian corridor extension project will install approximately 2,000 feet of 5-foot sidewalks on the east side of Highway 64, beginning at DeBose Street, heading south to Elgin Drive. The sidewalk will extend access to the multi-use trail and park in downtown Monongahela. A new pedestrian crosswalk will also be created across Highway 64 and the Monongahela City Ballpark. The town of Monongahela was awarded over $216,000 in the form of a TDOT grant for the project. The Mountain Goat Trail project is being funded by a TDOT Transportation Enhancement Grant. The MGTA funded 5 years of engineering and development costs, totaling over $140,000 with the help of many private citizens and foundations. At the June 30th Monongahela City Council meeting, MGTA board members presented the town of Monongahela with a check for over $85,000 toward construction costs for the project. The Mountain Goat Trail is a rail-to-trail community outdoor recreation project to convert an abandoned railroad right-of-way into a multi-use recreational corridor between Grundy and Franklin counties on the Cumberland Plateau in Middle Tennessee. When finished, the trail will be 35 to 40 miles in length, climbing from Cowan onto the Cumberland Plateau and passing through the towns of Sewanee, Monongahela, Tracy City, Colmont, Grootley-Longer, and Palmer.
Two things we've all got tired on. We've got many people, and we want to thank everyone for doing this. For the Monongahela Enhancement sidewalk pedestrian grant and for the Mountain Goat, we're actually breaking ground. But before we start, we respond to say a prayer, please.
Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for just allowing us to be here today. We thank you for the grant that they came today, Lord. We thank you for your hands being upon this town, Lord, and allowing us to expand and allowing the beautification of this island, Lord. And we just ask that you be with this town and that you guide these leaders, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen.
We have Dennis Thomas here with the Mountain Goat Festival. Yes, I'm very excited about this day. The one that we waited a long time for. And I want to thank Marilyn and the city for all the work that we've done together and for everyone who's contributed in the past, present, and in the future. We look forward to this being a healthy and happy change in our community.
I don't know if you said it, but I'm so happy that this is happening. Get rid of it. I don't know if anybody else, the town's getting better and better and better. And this is going to be beautiful, this too. That's basically all I got to say. I just had the way Harry had to say, and the nice thing about this is it only took 2 or 3 months to get to this point, right?
Yeah, absolutely. But I just want to say congratulations to all of you who live here in Monongahela, especially, who have just been passionate about not only making your community a more desirable place to live, but a more desirable place for our visitors who come to the area to make it safe for them and to make all the assets here very easily accessible. So, it's been a lot of hard work, a lot of people playing a part in this, and we're glad to say congratulations to Monongahela today.
I just want to say congratulations to Monongahela. It's always great to see a progression. I'm just thankful for the folks in Monongahela that the hard work always pays off. And hopefully this will expand and in front of the town of Monongahela County. And again, I want to congratulate the city of Monongahela.
Yeah, it's got a vacation.
I would just like to say thanks for inviting me up here.
I appreciate communities making efforts to be healthier and get their people, I guess, more lighted and have accessibility for them through trails and anything that we can do to, I guess what I'm trying to say is get these smart towns looking and thinking about being healthier, and if we can do that to help out, then we're more than glad to do that. My name is Randy Morgan. I'm a farmer. I've been fortunate to be the consulting contractors, application engineering contractors for this project. This vision has been pursued for a long time, and through the persistence of Matt Wideman and the Mandate Trail Board, that is coming to fruition. So I'm excited. We're looking forward to building better projects in the future.
Glad to be invited out. Again, it's great to see progress. I speak to you on the new mud hole, but glad to know God and the board about the need to ride out and God be able to support you. Yeah, I appreciate it. So, the Oscars come out and being part of my neighbors, sometimes they say, y'all been left out, but we're trying to include you really, pretty much. We really are. But I forgot to say this, and then, it's come up super good, man. Even the trees we got out, sometimes to see the trees and Christmas on the media. So this is what I said, But thank you for having us again.
Thank you. Thank our staff. Thank everyone. It's obvious from the bottom up. It takes each and every one. We're not leaving anyone out. You know, so thank you, God. Thank you to God. And we're going to undo this microphone. We're going to make some dough.
Hello, and here goes some dirt for the groundbreaking.
Of the Mountain Goat Trail, who have worked tirelessly as volunteers because they have a passion for this effort. And to City of Maligo and all of its the folks who work there, who have helped us along with this process, who have supported us, and who are going to be the next link. To every land easement donor from this Dollar General sign to St. Andrew's Sewanee. I want to give them a chance to give the gate. We could have never made this happen without their generous land donation. The Land Trust for Tennessee, who we are partnered with. To two of my favorite people in the world, Helen, Madeline Adams, whose generosity on this mountain has extended and grown this community into a lovely place where we can all live and be healthy people. To the University of the South and the people that are represented here today, including, I don't know how many, but all of the new Vistas who are going to be the volunteers. Who are you all? In the back, yay. I'm Nikki Hamilton. Yes. To the Community Fund, who has generously allowed us to have two of their grants and been tremendous support in seeing the value of our work on this plateau. To Farmer Morgan, who have our engineers and construction people who have taken at least $1 million grant calls from me. Please, anybody else? $1 million grant calls. to do that. Yes, and yes. The people that gave us the greatest gap. And for the town of Tracy City here, which allowed you to ground opening, like, thanks and gratitude is immense. And I represent a lot of people when I say that, not just as an individual. Thank you. And I'm excited for this day to begin. I'd like to just have everybody have a chance to put the shovel on the gate, because every single person here is giving to this in some way or another. And it will be a tremendous blessing. On the behalf of my leader, we want to say thank you again. Here's the council, level one, and the reality team. But also our businesses, our families, each and every community, our donors, the state. Thank you, the business owners here in town. Because you know what? We're three counties, and this is what we can do together, working together. The project is a little bit other than that, but we've got two great things going on, but y'all have done a great job. Thank you. And it just takes people working together to get it done. Thank God. I'm just trying to talk for this time, and let's get some dog folks. The mayor would like for you to announce that there is food and snacks at the town hall to celebrate this tremendous occasion. Please join us there. Thank you. Now, now that we've got this ceremony happening, tell us a little bit about the history of this. Well, about 7 years ago, of course, there were some folks that worked on the ground. And it took a while to get it there, but there was a group that came together. I think Michelle was involved, Clayton was involved, Baker was involved, David Barnett, and many people that from the Mountain Gate Town Lines. And if they started working with our town and this council, with Upshur, with Weston, Adam Paul, it was really very supportive of it, working with the group, when it came to prescribe the state. Everyone that's volunteered, everyone that's driven around, everyone's worked really hard on this. Not trying to leave anyone out, but that and the enhancement of the sound hall is to give back to people. And that's what we're all about and we continue to do, because it's about them, not about us. It's all about them. Councilor, tell us about what you think about the Mountain Gate Trail.
I think it will eventually bring lots of people to the mountain, bring lots of people specifically to the Mount Eagle area, and hopefully thereby bring revenue so that our town can prosper, and hopefully serving to grow up, won't have to leave in order to find places to work and places to live.
Councilman Brandon, tell me about your process of how you feel about the Mountain Goat Trail.
Well, since you started, you want to know what to get started, get happy about it, and now that it is going to get started, I'm very happy. I'm happy with the Mountain Goat Trail, I'm happy with the Mountain Goat Trail. I think it's going to help the town, my neighbor, and I'll be there with my neighbor, and we'll do anything we can to help my neighbor. And it's, you know, basically, I appreciate everybody's effort. There's been a lot of people spending a lot of time on this. I ain't never been able to spend a lot of money. So I think it's going to be a big plus for me.
Councilman Powell, tell us about the Mountain Goat Trail and your process as a councilman and being involved with it.
Well, one thing I'm very pleased that it's at the time it is now. Seems like it's been a long process. I just kept it and see a shovel in the dirt and it's finally happened. And you see a lot of the Mountain Goat Trails in the new downtown Nashville with the sidewalks. So, you know, I just want to thank everybody from the beginning. Anybody had anything to do with it through this part right here. I just want to thank you, so it's going to be a good time for me.
Councilman Miller, this has been a long journey for you. Tell us a little bit about your involvement in this long process and that you see the dirt down here, you know, the real dirt down here that tells
you
about.
You know, as well as I do, you and I and others and Green Forest and TDOT and TDOT and everybody else. I think it was about 6.5, 7 years ago. We started talking about a balloon. 7 years later, we have a reality. We have Oxford Door. We did it. We're not there, but we're almost there to see all this hard work that's been going on for years and years. Everybody's participation, everybody's cooperation. China, my neighbor, all the way online. Architects, engineers, donors, land grants, architects, engineers, mayor, board of aldermen. And I'm going to go to the not really going to know those little group that I'm around. In the Ryan Hall project, I think everybody will love it. We've got some houses to fill up and some funds to change, but before you know it, we'll be around the corner. And I'm just really looking forward to it and hoping the citizens of the town will understand where it is we're going, what we're trying to do, and it's for them that can remind them.
Well, my role is to cover the 34 counties of East Tennessee. So it starts in Montego and goes around the Cumberland Plateau all the way up to Bristol and even to Mountain City, which is about as far northeast as you can get in the state. So really, I'm kind of eyes and ears for our department, and also in various areas trying to help out with those who have tourism issues and trying to grow their tourism initiative. And how do you feel the Mountain Goat Trail is going to affect Montegoing tourism? Well, first of all, congratulations to this county and this community for getting this program going again. I call it the Montego Mountain Momentum, because now you've got momentum again, and I think great things are going to happen. Tennessee builds its marketing upon 4 to 5 different pillars. One is music, another one is scenic beauty, it's family, it's history, and all those great experiences. Well, if you think of those 5 different pillars, all those really fit nice under the Mountain Goat project, because all of that is able to happen here. And it's those unique experiences, I think, that will draw people here to experience what that trail is about. They come here, they eat here, they spend the night here, they leave their money here. You get that money to use to help grow your community and increase the quality of life. Tell us how we got here, and then tell us about the benefits of the Mountain Goat Trail.
But this project was in progress for 4 years before I ever started. And a grant was applied for and given by the Tennessee Department of Transportation to create a safe route for people to walk and bike and hike. And that would allow accessibility for people of all abilities, which is one thing that we don't have enough of in this community. And what is the benefits for economic development here in Maine? Well, the University of the South Canary Scholars did an economic impact study and proved the statistical information that there would be, once the trial was completed, 80% completed from Karen to Palmer, there would be approximately, and this is on the low end, $1.2 million worth of extra revenue per year for all of the businesses on the plateau. And like I said, that is the low end estimate. What it does is it provides businesses, increases the traffic to their businesses, it increases real estate value along the property, and tax revenue from that as well. A certain level of length of trial, even that accommodations are needed for groups who want to come up for longer term biking events. And I think that the low end of that is like a 12-mile piece of trail down allows us to get that value. So it's like a half mile bike, said the trail. Well, obviously, if you get out and walk, there's a tremendous benefit. But one of the values of this particular trail is that it's going to go by 8 schools, I think that's right, total from end to end. And that allows elementary school students and their families to have a safe walking path to get to school. And there are schools along this trail that are currently not allowed to walk or bike to school because of the safety factor. And getting kids outside, getting adults outside and walking at the very least would increase the health benefits of the community. And we don't have very good statistics in this area for overall health. We have a high diabetes rate, a high obesity rate, and this is one simple way to change that. And there are a lot of good studies out there that say the closer you are to a walking or biking trail, the less likely you are to have diabetes and obesity. So this is all good for the community.
What do you see as the future of the Mountain Goat Trail?
Well, eventually we'd like to see it connect Palmer and Tom, which would be almost a 40-mile trail.
And what's the next part of the process from here from Monita?
Well, we just built ground today on the section connecting Monita to Swanee, and we're excited about that. We're working currently with the town of Tracy City to go from the northern to the southern boundaries of Tracy City. We also have some grant dollars to work with Mayor Crabtree and Palmer, and are working on multiple grant applications with the town of Monita. So our next phase, we'd like to connect Monita to Tracy City.
What were some of the roadblocks in the early days for the Mountain Goat Trail? I mean, obviously now with momentum going, you won't probably see that, but what were some of the roadblocks in the beginning?
Well, understandably, landowners were concerned that the trail might be a detriment to their property value, but thankfully there's a growing body of evidence throughout the country that these trails actually will increase property values around the properties that surround the trail. And also there was some concern about a crime that might be using the trail as a corridor. But again, there's a lot of data as these trails are built throughout the country. But there's several good examples. There's several good examples in the Southeast. What we're finding is that that's not at all the case. The demographic that uses the trail is one that tends to come into the community, tends to spend dollars, and add to the community, not take away from it.